Hey folks, Dr. Groovy here, Scott Grove of GroovyMusicLessons.com. Once again, people wanted to just see the guitar collection, where it's at this particular day, which would be 69. Yes, 69 in the year 2015. Okay, so it's dang near midnight, and it'll be 6:10 or 11 by the time this gets uploaded. So yeah, we'll go through all the guitars. To keep some people reminded of what's going on, at least a year or two ago, some folks sent a guitar here to give to a sick child if I could find one, and there's more stuff here. Multi-effects, brand new here, big Digitech unit with every effect in the world, and I still can't get rid of them for nothing. Nobody will take it. They're not allowed to accept it. So if anybody, you know, if you guys want those back, I've got your guitars, your effects, everything that's supposed to be donated to people. I don't know what's wrong with the world, but not one single hospital, any kind of place. I mean, every possible thing I've checked, even the schools, will not accept gifts, you know, for sick children as they were intended to be. So if you want them sent back, let me know. If not, I'll keep trying, but got somebody else's guitar here. It was kind of Jimmy's guitar. He sent it to me just to check it out. Very cool axe. Anyway, reason I'm even just starting in here is because, yeah, goofy people tend to think that I live in mom's basement. So yeah, I just cure that every time I can. You like my tumbleweed? Mr. and Mrs. Woodworker, my email thing. Yes, because I built junk out of wood, distressed Western furniture and stuff, and it's the kind of junk I built here. Everything in the house I made. Let's see. So let's go into the guitar room, which is not in my mom's basement. Yes, me and my lovely wife. This was, 10 years ago at her son's wedding. We got her daughter and two of the grandkids coming in from Florida tomorrow. So I actually picked up a couple of cheaper guitars today. Okay, as you can see, just in case they want to take some home, they did the whole cross-country trip from Florida all the way to Nevada here. So, yeah, here's the... It's not the basement. It's just the music room. And I have added a lot of lighting in here, just trying to get it not so dismal. Reason it's always so dark in here is because, I mean, the windows, both sets, are just covered with amps and guitars, and you just can't see anything. Okay, so guitar time and everything else. I usually try to start, I don't know, let's pick a corner and try not to get bored. It could be a lengthy thing. Okay, first of all, what do we got? The banjo ukulele looking thing from Eddie Finn. These things are a piece of crap, so don't order anything from that guy. I finally got it to play fine, but yeah, straight out of the box, crap. Okay, the Washburn acoustic electric. This one I actually really dig. They got it in a natural also, but I really like that. And people are like, is that your only classical wax? It's the only one I need. I just needed it for some Willie Nelson on stage, and this thing does the job. No feedback out of this sucker, and gives me all the sounds I need. So it's all the more classical stuff I really do anyway, so does a perfect job. Let's see, just straps and more straps. So many of you have made for me. People like to, for some reason, make up so many things about me, saying that I hate everything that's not made in America. No. Everybody says I hate Gibsons. No. I might hate the people who run the place or think they do a lot of things stupid, but no, I actually prefer... there's a lot of Gibson guitars. Hell, rack full of them. Are they all wonderful? No. But, so, you know, some of my favorites, I don't even have them here. Because I just don't. But yeah, all the crap that you hear about me is wrong. Everybody messes everything up. And yeah, I do tend to like the foreign stuff more than the American stuff. So 3,000 posts you'll read all over the internet about me being a U.S. snob on guitars. No, these are both from Mexico, and I love these. And I don't know, I've only got a couple American Fenders in here, I think. So this one here, the FMT Flame Maple Top and the Tobacco Sunburst. They also offered this and Cherry Sunburst. It's very cool. Here's a green to blue sparkle flip-flop. Another Mexican one. There's a couple little amps up here lurking around. My Spamocaster that a lovely gentleman made for me. This is my Pufferfish. Just so you guys know, your gifts are still here too. Okay, the infamous piece of junk. Yeah, I got junk stuff too. The Dean 6-string banjo. Got my Luna acoustic electric 8-string ukulele. I really love that. My old Martin. Let's get down here. What do we need in here? Will it focus? DC 16 GTE gloss top something. Okay, so it's one of those. I had bought that new when it came out. See, the Ibanez Iceman ukulele, which should have been electric when it came out, but it never was. Nobody ever knew they even existed, and they're gone. So I went ahead and Paul Stanleyized another one. I couldn't find one anywhere, so I found a guy in Germany and paid him three times what these go for, just because I couldn't find one. Then I electrified it. And, hey, made a cool one. This one here I just got a few days ago. And got the preamp and everything all inside here. I'm loving ukuleles just all over the place. I love this little Ibanez thing, man. That thing's been sweet. Sweet as all get out. Love that thing. Which one is it? Out of all of them, I tend to like whatever that says in there, that's what it is. But that one just turned out best out of everything. What else is over here? Oh, actual real Native American flutes from a guy, and he's on my website. You can get them built yourself out of anything you want them made out of. I've even got my recorder here. If you want to, you know, you've got something going on fifth grade and somebody needs to borrow a recorder, I got one. What is this? Some kind of a, I think it's a Silver Creek or something, electric fiddle. There's the infamous strum stick. There's lessons on here, free ones for that. The PV power slides, big old square neck, open tunings, and play it sitting down like a dobro, or play it standing up like a slide guitar, whatever you want to do, but I love these. I've got three of those around here, and just the three colors they came in. Knob right here, tone knob, actually changes the pickup from single coil to humbucker, and you've got, you know, tonal ranges between that, so you start off in single coil, then you go dropping it down and it takes your tone down, then all of a sudden you hit a point and the humbucker kicks in with the tone wide open, and then you start rolling that tone off. So very ingenious idea. Another tuning on that one, and another tuning on that one, and they're just very cool. So I love these things and would not part with these over any other ones out there. What's just laying on the ground from the 1920s, the K mandolin. Yes, it plays fine and dandy. Okay, you guys looking for some guitars, let's see. This one I've got a few of, brand new, still in the bags, never open. That's the Paul Reed Smith SEEG with the Budweiser finish, and even Budweiser on the headstock. So I do have a couple few of these extra. I'm laying around. I've got them in bags back here and in the closet and everywhere. Great axes. One thing they never should have ever quit making. So these are getting extremely expensive now with the stop tailpiece. You can get the ones with the whammy here. They just sound bad for some reason. I don't know what it is, but they just sound wrong. I've had plenty with the whammy, and just one after another, just do not stack up to these. I can buy these any day, and they always sound the same with a stop tailpiece. But something about that whammy being in there just messes everything up. People are like, well, hardtail it. It makes no difference. It really doesn't. There's just something about the hardtails here, and I will swear to the end of my days that it's the only way to get them, but easily one of the coolest guitars ever in the world. And from Korea, I prefer these much more than the U.S. ones. I've had plenty of U.S. ones, and I still have U.S. ones. But again, I would rather play these any day of the week than most anything I have. Same here. Another Korean one. They made the Parker. This is called the P30. This is actually a Korean one. They did them in Indonesia. They did them in China. Every year they did them somewhere else. This was actually Korea, so that's why I got it. Korea is just known for pulling out, you know, world music. They do a lot of great stuff. See, more lights up here, and added what I could so you guys could see. That thing is phenomenal, and it doesn't matter whether it has the whammy or not. It just works. You have no choice. It's going to have a whammy. Okay, right here you got the USA version. This is the first version and the best version. There is a new Mexican version, but something 5. But this is your, oh God, what the hell was it? Something V. My brain is so gone, guys. I'm sorry. But I'll do best I can. And yes, it will take me forever to get through these. But this is the one. Yeah, it takes the double A's in the back. But it has the whole Roland system built in. You can go to, yes, the pickups can work, or you can use no pickups at all, except for the Roland pickup back here. There is not a MIDI out. It just uses all the onboard stuff, which is half the guitar is carved away in the back, full of MIDI stuff. But you can do, you know, pseudo tellies, a different strat, a couple humbuckers in here, pick which ones you want. Every tuning possible, some acoustic instruments, dadgads and baritones and everything in the world just right from your guitar there, and everything sounds beautiful. So, and plus you can turn all that crap off and just play the 3 pickups that are in it. So that's an American axe there. So quite boring as far as I go, usually, being a straight sunburst, but great axe. And again, Mexico is producing these now. For, you know, a third of the money, of course. But I got this one really cheap for like $650. Dang near brand new. It was a Craigslist thing, and met a nice little Mormon guy 35 miles down the street and grabbed him, and he needed the money, and I didn't need this, but hadn't bought anything that day. Okay, here is the, see if I can get around the light to get in there. The flip out. Okay, you guys, what? Made by the Dewey Decibel Company, which no longer makes axes. Let me see if I can pull my guitar, meaning one of my custom-made ones, out of the way. There you go. So it's just the neck on the wrong side of the guitar. And yes, they did all their guitars that way. That was their thing. They're, of course, no longer around. Okay, good old David Anderson and my SG-1. Nice, that's purple metal flake. I don't know what it looks like there, but no knobs. On and off switches for each of the silver lace sensors. And then a big kill switch. And that's all you need. Of course, we have the LSR. And then staggered tuners there so that they, no need for string trees. So locking tuners and a roller, anything we can find. Superb axe. I'll start on the front, I guess, and try to sneak in between because this is just going to be tough for me. And I'm not moving everything. I'm still kind of in a lot of pain, so from my sciatica thing. Okay, so here you got an 84 Gibson. I love this guitar, and it's a great country guitar, great blues guitar. Every guitar you can play everything on, but love shocking people. Yes, that's a stock finish, the camo, the Explorer 3. Okay. 1984. They made a lot of these. I've had a few of them, and I love it. Just the whole 3P90 thing is really neat. It just takes the sharp end off the Fender thing, takes the whoomp off the Gibson end normally, and it's just a nice place to meet in the middle with that guitar. So you can get every combination in the world on there, which is great. It's my actual 1976 limited edition. Some will say that on the back of the headstock, some won't. This one was actually made in 1975. Everything inside is 75. Blah, blah, blah. Perfect mint condition. I wasn't going to have it any other way. There's some guitars I was going to splurge on. Others, I don't give a crap. And these just, like that one just hangs here. It will never go to a gig. It's just here because I wanted one. Okay? This one here, you saw, old dumbass, Phil X had this one for Fretted Americana, who I recently just disowned. All of them. You can ask why if you want, and I'll decide if I want to tell you. Anyway, yeah, the three humbuckers in there, middle knob, will turn on and off the middle pickup in there. So very cool sound. You can go listen to Phil X play that or listen to me. Again, every guitar I have, there is a review on it. Every single one, except for the brand new ones I got, maybe a dozen of them. But they're all on my website. Every ones I've had before this, since I started actually keeping track of them just a couple years ago. But they're all on my website. If you find Fender, you'll find every Fender review. If you want to see what guitars I actually have at any given time, it's on my website. If I sell one, it's gone off my website. So it's always 100% current and accurate. So everybody's like, what do you have nowadays? It's on my website. If it's on there, I have it. If it's not on there, I sold it. Okay, so it's just that easy. Nobody, for some reason, ever listens to that. Here is just a groovy Explorer 2. So the E2. Da-da-da-da. Lots of brass and stuff, so which was cool back in 80. Which is about right where this is. And just, you know, the cool tailpiece and cool carvings on it. And that's walnut, the dark part, and maple sandwiched in between. And here's its brother, the V2. Same thing. This one here is either a 79 or an 80. But they also did a flip-flop version where it was maple on top, you know, nice and blonde looking, and then the walnut in the middle. Great sounding single coils here. Bill Lawrence. These are the same pickups that are in my G3 grabber bass and in the S1, Gibson S1 guitars. Same thing, just split in half. One reverse wound, blah, blah, blah. But they are single coil, but they are hum canceling the way they did it. Very cool. The most expensive guitar I have around here at the moment is this perfect 1964 Firebird 5 mint. There is nothing to be found wrong with this thing, and the whammy somehow actually works, so it's 100% original and a very expensive axe. So yeah, cool shit. I got this one because I love Marauders and S1s and stuff, but then again, I've always been a little Kiss nut since I was a kid, and I just never let go of it. You know, it's just, hey, I'm not going to be ashamed of who I dig or what. I don't listen to anything anymore, but that's the one that you see on the Kiss t-shirts, the Marauder Custom. Okay, it's the only Marauder that has inlays like that. All the rest of them have dots. But that one has the toggle switch. This here's a 1975. They did them in 75 and 76. Later on, they put a blend control in between those volume and tone. And at one point, they got rid of the toggle switch and put a blend control there, which I actually like better, but if I got that one, which I had, but I don't anymore, then it would not be the actual KISS model guitar. Everybody's always like, this is the one Paul Stanley smashed. No, Paul used to smash Marauders, but they were seconds, and they had them in big boxes in the semi that are, for smashing only. And he'll bring them out. They're barely able to hold tune, and they're all just natural colors or crappy. But he did not smash the customs. So any customs that are out there, he would not smash those. He actually played those. Okay, I just got this guitar back. What do you mean I got it back? Yeah, my buddy Jim, I sold this to him a couple years ago and wish I would have never got rid of it. And he was kind enough to send it back, and I just showed you his guitar case in the other room. He sent me a real groovy Yamaha Weddington axe, a special. I'll do a review on that here shortly. But he's also got some of my old Corvus 3 guitars, the blue ones and stuff. But this axe is a 93 Gibson Les Paul Studio Light M3. So you got switches here, which will do three single coils or two humbuckers. So you can do the entire Strat thing or the entire Les Paul thing like nobody's business. And a beautiful, just honey-colored, hardly any burst at all, which is what I dig. And it's just such a fabulous guitar. And I do plan on playing it. Original parts, only one that is off of here that's in the guitar case now as I put the roller bridge on. Because I'm going to go play this sucker. It's just that cool of a guitar. And again, reviews on everything. So here's the Ace Frehley 1 of 300 1997 custom shop Les Pauls with the wrong pickups, but more than half of them had the wrong pickups, and there's a whole story on that here online. I'm sure you guys have read it. If not, check it out. All 100% true. And probably the worst guitar I have right there. Worth a lot of money, but it's just a hunk of junk. This one is fabulous. What a difference between that and this. That I was just so happy to get that one back. All right, let's see if I can mill on through. Here's a couple of custom ones I had made. This here was done by a place here in Utah. Ibanez refused to do a beautiful axe like this, so I did the Iceman here with the three lay sensors. Again, not a single knob anywhere. Just a five-way switch, another switch here where I could get all the seven positions, and then a spring-loaded kill switch, the Paul Stanley-looking appointment, very thick binding. Yes, that's binding, not paint. White, matching, maple fingerboard, and again, compensated height. Tuners on it, so there's no string trees or none of that crap. Best axe I ever heard, and it weighs nothing, like 6 pounds. And then these PRS ones are almost 6 pounds, and they're pretty close, man. They're just a different feeling axe, but man, just superb guitars. So that's my, if anybody asks what's your favorite axe in the world to take on stage play, period, it's this one, and any PRS SEEG with a stop tailpiece. You notice I went for the stop tailpiece on here too, because it just does something. I'm not going to question it because it works. Okay, David Anderson again. Made me, this here came after the Ibanez Destroyer looking thing, but we actually, this is called the Groovy 32. This is all done in 24 karat gold leaf, actual gold tuners at an angle so you can reach them, just like on the bases. My roller nut, three lace sensors. Where are they at? I have the silvers, and there's currently a couple of Duncan hot rail, cool rail. It's just five on and off switches, one for each pickup. This one does have knobs, so you got a volume knob and a tone knob if you need it. But no toggle switches, no five-way, but you got five on and off switches. So you can have five pickups on if you want. So you have three real single coils, two real humbuckers. So you get the real deal. You got some more Paul Stanley-ish stuff going just with the stars and the fretboard. So cool stuff. Now I'm just going to have to move stuff to get to stuff. May not get the greatest shots, but I'm not going to move too much. Another made in Mexico. Strat right here, only a couple hundred of those. Love it, even on the headstock. If you watch that video, focus right under. That's wood grain, kids. So, isn't that sharp? Those are very cool. And that was one I had a long time ago, and then I had sold it. Then I got another one like it. It's not the exact same one back, but I got another perfect one back. Okay, back here, I actually changed one. Paul Reed Smith, SEEG again. I hate white pickguards. So this is just like the Budweiser one. I just threw a black pickguard on that I had custom made, and pickup covers that actually cover over the pole pieces, which I thought looked great, and they do not interfere with the whole magnetic field, so very cool. And I play a very percussive style, finger picking, and like to slam my strings into the pole pieces, so that keeps them quiet. So if I do it that way, which is the reason behind originally going to lay sensors, because I will slam, you know, I'm just banging away, and I'm always constantly hitting the strings against them pole pieces, and you know how that sounds coming out of the amp. Sounds like crap, so found a way to shut them up. Okay, what do we got back here? Well, while we're here, a few more things. Here, it's all covered with stuff, ready for some guitar stuff, but this is my Deckley pedal steel. Love the pedal steel. Big time. Just don't get to play it as much as I'd love to. Some great buddies of mine threw me in. I got this in today. The PV Falcon USA. Just had one pickup changed out. And it needs a truss rod cover and a back spring trim cover. Everything else is original. It's got the Kaler original. Falcons are one of their best axes they ever made. Superb guitar. Thanks, guys. I just got to finally plug it in like 2 minutes before I turn this on. Anyway, old 70s Washburn 5-string. Sounds awesome. Washburn, I can't speak highly enough of. Of course, they make their crap stuff too. But too many people overlook Washburn. The MM50, the Epiphone, mandolin. They make the electric version too, which is just an electric pickguard. It's got a couple knobs on there. You can slap it on. Cost you about $150 extra to slap that on there. But hey, one of the couple Epiphones I actually have. Here's my little cheap Regal resonator. No, these are not Dobros. Dobro is a brand. So my square neck resonator. Okay, so remember that. You guys don't have a Dobro unless it says Dobro on the headstock. Okay, just a little pet peeve I have. One of many. Okay, what do I got? I gotta do this. The purple Metal Flake 7-string Squire. Yep. And what do they call these? Like a Stage Master? And I took the pole pieces out of one coil in each of the pickups and made them silent single coils. So they are not humbucking. They're nice and twangy for country. So the nice sparkly 7-string. Back here we have the Casio MG, meaning MIDI guitar. Does great. Sounds phenomenal. It's just a Strat looking thing. But it does so well on its own. But then it's just, the tracking is wonderful if you just run a MIDI cord into any synthesizer. And you can change all the patches from here, blah, blah, blah. But one of the best MIDI controllers out there. There's a 310 also from Casio that is awesome. All this 80s stuff, and it kicks butt over what's out today. Hell, I've got my DG20 Casio thing here. Nylon looking little strings, but that doesn't do horrible. It is quirky, but yeah, it plugs into all the synths and stuff. This here is cool. Never been to a gig. Custom shop, Fender. Fender Plus Ultra or some crap. But here's the only one you'll ever see that had the Wilkinson roller nut in gold. It's the only one they ever did in gold. So they do exist right here. And some of these things, when I say gold, I mean there's actually gold in the Thar Hills. But a monster axe, but just so pristine and original that it'll probably never get played. It's sad, but that's the way it is. Here's the Epiphone version of the old Scotty Moore ES-295. This one doesn't have the trapeze thing. It's got a little Bigsby deal. They actually had a real Bigsby on these at first, and then just threw on the Epiphone Bigsby. Got a couple P90s that howls like an old hound dog when you plug it in, of course, just like it's supposed to. Got the floral pick guard there. I need to put some kind of roller saddles if I ever actually want to play this. Stuff it full of tube socks so it won't feed back. But it could be an interesting guitar if I can somehow keep that bastard in tune. Okay, another one. This is an amazing guitar, more than any of you will ever give it the credit for being. And I can't show it well enough. You can watch the video. It's a guitar I had actually sold and bought it back. And never should have sold it. But people are always kind enough to offer me my guitars back before they sell them to other people. This was a custom shop Fender before there was a custom shop. John Cruise, the most famous guy in the custom shop before, like I said, there was a custom shop, he made this. So this is the very first Telecaster ever made with those kind of fret markers. And just amazing, of course. If John Cruise does it, it's going to be top of the line. But you just can't beat this sucker. It's amazing. 83-ish, and then he actually ended up with some like 87 hardware on here. And just little bits and pieces of everything, but in his spare time. So, groovy stuff, of course, USA custom shop. But again, before there was a custom shop. Okay. See if you guys can even see this one. I can never remember the name of the guy that did this. You guys will remember. I just quit trying to write to him to have more made up, because anybody that does not have a website is not getting my business. He has a website, and this is the only guitar on there, but he has his Facebook page with all the other new stuff on it. But I do not belong to Facebook, and I never will, so if that's all people have for a web page, I'm no longer ordering from you. But this is actually called the Guitarded Caster. Nice guy, does great work. All gold lace sensors here. Three on and off switches, but it's a completely acrylic guitar, which of course sounds like this guitar. Why? Because wood on electric guitar is not influential and hardly any way at all, if any, in the sound of your electric guitar once it's plugged into your amp, as we know. Okay, my pink paisley Strat that I use forever and ever and ever, amen, on the road. It's seen its days in Japan, except for it has American electronics out of a Strat Plus, and then it's got a regular American standard pickups. Don't know why, it's just something over the years that was put together little by little by little and became the monster it is. Okay, two axes from the UK, from Brian Eastwood. Okay, check this out. This is the Bender Distortocaster. again, you have to really see the reviews to know how beautiful these things are. They are phenomenal and almost impossible looking until you get behind it. Then you're, oh, I get it. And here's his Bent Marvel, the big bubblegum pink one. That thing is wacky. Wacky as all get out. Again, from these angles, you're not going to see much just how cool they are. But please check out all my individual reviews on things. Okay, underneath here is a Crook. Mr. Crook makes everything, all the Paisley stuff for Brad Paisley. This is the Telly Bird with the green Sherwood Forest green paisleys. I threw the Babix bridge on there. I threw a lace sensor here in the middle. Then you got the little mini humbucker here. I threw an on and off switch for the middle pickup. Blah, blah, blah. So just, I'm not fond of two pickup guitars. Just not my thing. This was my surprise of the year right here. I finally discovered, well, not that I discovered, but I finally bought my first Reverend guitar and realized just how amazing they are. Any Reverend guitar, I'd say get it. Any of them. Whatever pickup configuration is your thing, you can trust these guys to make amazing access all the way down the line. I can't imagine a bad guitar coming from them. Based off the Volcano series, that's where from the late, great Ron Ashton signature model, but I just changed this to a roller bridge instead of the Tune-O-Matic. Hate Tune-O-Matics, and I put a lovely snake back here as a tailpiece. But just the three P90s are amazing, and of course, everything is made out of the white Lemba. Every single guitar they have, period. As you know, or as you might call it, Carina. Every guitar they make is made out of that. And the bass roll-off is a saver, especially for these three P90s. They make the P90s sound like Fender, nice, quacky, or spanky sounds. Or you can have the nice bluesy P90s. All thanks to that one little bass roll-off, which is on every guitar they have. So, quite the beautiful thing. And it has the raised part here in the middle, which will be just like the Firebird here. So it's just like that. Amazing guitar. I can't wait to take that one out and play all my country licks, which, yes, I am a country boy. The older, and give me some Marty Robbins and that kind of stuff. That's where I'm at. And of course, all the outlaw stuff. Waylon Willie, Merle, Cash, all that stuff. Give me that stuff. And I love to play it on weird axes. Okay, probably the best, in my opinion, stock Fender guitars ever made are these James Burton things from the USA. Are they even a custom shop? I can't remember. But I've had all these and I bought a few back. And they got the S1 switches located right here. It's a push button in the volume, which will switch it from series to parallel wiring, which gives you a nice boost and gives you almost a humbucking sound, but you get what's also called strato-tele switching. Put it in the middle, and so you don't have the middle pickup, you have the neck and the bridge together, which is a nice change. You can actually get the tele sound out of a tele. It's not wired like a Strat. Makes it nice. So does that finish up that wall? I think that finishes up that wall. Okay. Oh, laying down here on the floor. I just redid this one recently, just a couple days ago. Washburn has a cheap old company, whatever, their import Lion thing. And never thought I'd like such a thing, but I got it knowing exactly what I would do to it. And that was, there you go, dropping these pickups and all these electronics in it. From the Mexican, the brand new 2015, just basic, standard Stratocaster HSH, which stands for humbucker, single humbucker. All the new ones that have that have a coil that is covered with a chrome thing that you cannot take off, and black on the bevels. Same on the humbucker down there. But they do not put the chrome on the middle one. I keep putting the chrome on the middle ones. But with Fender, it's just black. So everything in 2015 on their humbuckers and stuff on the Mexican ones, they have that chrome there on top. Chrome and black, and then they'll have chrome and black back here. But that'll just be black here. But you pull out on here. Switches them all to single coils, so all the chrome coils will work. So they do it just opposite of Ibanez, and it works perfectly. Ibanez would have the middle one on, and then the two black ones, which are real close to each other. Sonically, not a beautiful thing. You'll never get a Strat sound, but people are like, I know, if you want to sound like a Strat, get a Strat and not an Ibanez. Whatever works for you, kids. There's enough guitars for all of us, so order what you like. So I bought this strictly because I think it looks amazing. And I bought the Strat that these actually go to, also from Stratosphere. And then I bought the brand spanking new Strat also, which I'll show you shortly. But amazing guitar, and I can't wait to play that Wild Beast. It turned out amazing. So I can't wait to play that on your Cheating Heart and all that stuff. I love the pointy guitars, but hard to find any with single coils. Okay, from Korea. Okay, so who knows where this is from? I haven't even looked it up. I don't care. It's just a great guitar. So now I'm getting away from America stuff. Here we are in Korea. This is not the Atkins thing. This is the TC90 in a vintage white with two Seymour Duncan P90s that actually sound good. I finally found a Duncan that sounds good. I've got reviews on this on here. What can you say about these? I mean, look, that's the neck joint. All the plastic is still on this thing. Focus. There you go. So, again, all the Korean stuff, we know where it's all made at over there. And it's just top-notch stuff. So, a great blues axe here, semi-hollow, and just, again, that's the plastic still on it, so that sucker has not been used. Pardon my weird camera angles while I put that away. Okay, let's go across the front. Very expensive here. Merle Haggard, the Tough Dog Telly. Okay, so not the Kotsen model. This one costs like three times what that one does. These are like $7,000 now. You can still get them, I think. But there you go, the Tough Dog with his little Tuffy Dog. But the Merle Haggard, just as sweet as telly as you can get. Not quite as sweet as those, though, for what I do. You know, it's missing one pickup, but it does have a four-way switch, so you get a few different options. Here's the Strat I was telling you about from Mexico, $499 here in 2015. That's all it cost you. They make it in a double humbucker model or a double humbucker with a single coil in the middle, which is what this is. I just kind of blinged it out and put some more chrome on there. And then I did put these roller saddles on there. Same bridge. But I just kind of blinged this sucker out with a little more chrome. But you can get these right now. And again, you pull out on the back tone knob. Everything goes three single coils, push it back in. Then you got the humbuckers. So Fender finally went there. Okay, here's the Giles, is how you spell it. Roland Giles, back in 1996, came up with this axe. It's called the KT400. There you go. And I come to find out that these Bill Lawrence, or Wild Bill, are original to the guitar. He came out with these back in 96, 97. Tried to open up shop back then he let his license lapse, and then finally opened up the company again in 2012. So this is the only guitar out of that original thing. It said they offer them in this color and that color. It never happened. This is it. amazing guitar. It's not made of wood at all. It's PR, polyresin. Okay, I had to think of Puerto Rico in my head in order to remember PR for polyresin. It's what the whole body's made out of. Just a flat out smoking axe, and he doesn't make anything like these anymore. Everything else, look, Everything he makes now looks like airline guitars and Dan Electro crap, and they're still composite materials, but he's not doing this. This looks kind of like the Fender Swinger, if you ever look it up. But superb acts, I'll do reviews on all these shortly. This was a great find. Somebody on my, just one of my friends here on YouTube, put up a link to a guy that had a few guitars for sale that he had kind of redone and reshaped. So this is just, again, another Mexican Strat that was just blinged to the max and carved so specially and is just phenomenal and gorgeous. And even the headstock has a great carve in it. This is just amazing. You can't believe this. From RS Guitar Works, the TV. Yep, the Tele-V. Okay, which I got back a hold of. This is a pine body. Okay, with the Tele stuff. I didn't like the, I don't know, it had a P90 up there originally and something else down here, so I put real pickups in it, as far as I'm concerned. there's a review with the old pickups also on here, so you can check it out in its original formation. And the headstock now has Groovy, Dr. Groovy, with a big V on there. But, yeah, I just put a Strat situation going on in there and put the three pickups in, and it's very, there you go. It looks like it's been played for a million years, but it hasn't. Of course, it's just distressed and such nonsense. Okay, this is the real Steve Vai gem, the acrylic one that everybody goes crazy over. And again, ta-da, there you go. It's got the LEDs. And it's autographed by Steve here on the back of the headstock. Groovy axe. One of the only axes I have that actually has a working heavy-duty, you know, whammy on it that works. So, quite the expensive little piece of machinery. But it's just here because. It's not like I would actually ever use it, but it's here. Okay, the USA, Paul Reed Smith. Move this out of the way. Okay, this is the 305 in Grandma Hannah Pink, which I think is cool. I've had the blue ones too. Just straightforward five-way switch, volume and tone. USA, Paul Reed Smith. And that cost five times what these do, but these kick their ass from Korea. For me, I would much rather play those than I would this. And this sounds phenomenal and plays great, but the other one just has something special. Don't know. Okay, let me dig in the back here. Dillion. Always John Dillion always makes some cool axes. The Mother Toilet Seat Cherry Sunburst Strat. Brand new for 2015. All kinds of new stuff. He puts out just superb axes. So I had to get one this year. Bought that one brand new. Have yet to do a review on it. So all these, a lot of them on this line, I have yet to do a review on. Here's the old Steve Miller. Yep, the Steve Miller. That axe, yeah, the Fly Like an Eagle axe. Here it is. So not quite an Iceman yet. They had a model number back then. And you got the like five-way Veritone switch thing and a triple coil pickup. So these were cool. This is before Icemans were known as Icemen. Okay. So yes, that's Steve Miller. And when he takes his time, he will do a long, weird leaf thing. If he don't like you, he'll just do a quick signature. Okay, one of these, you guys don't see them very often, but they are great guitars, and they are plywood. This is actually orange or pink or something, or red, depending on how it looks here. This is the lower model of the Charvel. So there was Jackson, then Charvel, then the baby one is Charvette. Baby meaning it just didn't cost much because it's a plywood body. These things sound a flippin' amazing. I probably had 20 of these damn things. Just a great no pick guard neon colored axe that sounds like a Strat and looks, you know, you can pick the guy's nose next to you with the reverse headstock. They make them with the headstocks both ways. But if you see one of those, get one, if you so desire. Over here is another James Burton. This is the most expensive Burton one just because of the finish. Currently, these are at $1,700 on Musician's Friend. They discontinued this one last year, this finish, this white pearl, and it was at $2,200 just because of the finish. So I had sold all my Burtons, and then I bought back my favorite ones. Again, not the exact ones, but this one here has a neck from 1994 on it, but they actually didn't release it till 2006. Same as that one over there, but they had a lot of leftover Burton necks from previous years and decades gone by. Okay, let's just keep on rolling. It never starts here. let's see. If you guys care, I actually do use this cheap-ass, what is it, PSR 292 Yamadog for my top keyboard, my Kurzweil SP76 stage piano, and believe it or not, yes, Casio WK3500. This has got some of the best flipping sounds I ever heard in my life. Just amazing. And it's a toy, but it sounds better than this thing. But that's got, excuse me while I burp on everything, all the weighted, you know, weighted keys and stuff. Oh, great Heart Key Kickback 12. That thing sounds amazing, especially when you throw compression right up there on top of it. Superb little bass amp for little gigs. Tons of Johnson J8 controllers here for all the different Johnson J stations that are down here and over here and over here. And I got the Johnson Millennium here, the Fender Concert 2 here, a bunch of PA crap here, some old art junk, my Tascam 2488. I still love that as far as a hard disk recorder instead of the computer recording, the great Con strobe tuners. My speakers up here for In the Room. The full stack of the Johnson Millennium JM250, so a 250-watt version of this with two of the 412 cabinets. Here's another Johnson Millennium with a 212 cabinet under it. Here's the Johnson Marquee JM120. A rack of mini tuners, not as many as you're getting ready to see. There's a Johnson JT50 up here, and a Marquee Johnson JM60 amp up there. Bass amp, all kinds of stuff, but mainly the Ashdown 410 T's. Amazing. A whole stack of those. Got a Heartkey 5500 right here. My synth modules that I use on the bass, two different ones. Here's a little mixer for those, a six-channel mixer, so you can mix in the different synth sounds, wireless tuners. Another Heartkey 3500, and then nine more tuners going up there. Okay. So let's go on to some more guitars, shall we? See what we can see. Okay, up there, there's the Alvarez 12-string acoustic electric. Love that thing. It's, again, every one of these have reviews. Go check them out. One of the finest sounding 12-strings I ever found, and I got it for $200. I love it. Look here. The USA Washburn. You guys haven't seen this since I did this to it, the PT3, from USA, major heavy metal axe, and it's been redone. There you go. It's just like this one, but it's from the USA, and I Dr. Groovied it right there, and somebody stuck the EMG 81s and 85s in there, took out the center knob, and put a big old boost switch in there. So you get like 20 dB of boost, as much as you want. Just so big ass frets. This is a pure, this is a rhythm crunch metal machine. Sanded off, somebody sanded off the back of the neck there. And they put a hole here to adjust the preamp, boost. So you can get right there and do it real quick. Slick ass axe, but that's another one I haven't got to do a review on yet. It'll be coming soon. But yeah, I just thought I'd go to the truck stop and get some all the Dodge Ram letters and then a little skull thing, and wham, Dr. Groovy everywhere. That's just that. I don't know why it's got a huge 50s neck on it, so it's that's going to be a killer, just heavy rhythm axe. Because the neck is so huge, I can't imagine playing lead on it, but this sucker, yeah. But this is just, I mean, it's just meant for just crunching your ass off, which is, always a fun thing. Okay, let's see what's hidden back here. Okay, this one's getting ready to get a facelift, which is that newish. I got it, well, it's new old stock, the Copper Burst Mexican Strat that I got very cheap, and it's perfect, had all the plastic on it, brand new, never owned. Can't wait to get all my new stuff in so I can bling it out and show it to you. This one I've got today, which is, it makes no difference if you can see it or not, it's made by, it's not made by them, but this is one of them cheap telecopies made by a company called, they put Austin on the headstock. But it's just a telecopy. Like I said, the grandkids are coming in town tomorrow, and one of them will probably walk away with that. So that's why I get those things. Or to cut them up and do little science projects on here and so forth. Back here in the hole. There you go. Yamaha. I was telling you guys on some of my most recent stuff, quit spending money on brand new Epiphones and Squires and crap, and go out and get old Yamaha stuff. Look at that SSC500. Amazing. That is a phenomenal axe. And you can get these for nothing. Three on and off switches. Every combination. Screw those five-way switches. I also got this one for $225. Aria Pro. Right there. Three P90s. Stock. Lift up the knob and it turns on the center. P90, and yeah, this is one of them old suckers, and I'm trying to get in here to show you this. That is a great axe, man. So $225 on that and $10 shipping. Here's one of my guitars that has herpes. One of the Ibanez exotic wood ash acoustic electric things. It's hard to find one that is doesn't have a big hump in the neck, but once you do find one, it's a keeper. But you got to go through about 80 of them to get them. It's very in the dark, so it's not nearly as beautiful as it is in the review. So check out the review on that one. Okay, let's see. Move that PRS out of the way. There is a 1978 Ibanez Iceman right here, an IC100 BK. With the old flying fingers pickups, as people like to call them. So, I had these when I was a kid. A bunch of these, you could get them for nothing. But that sucker is about pristine. I wish I could show it to you better, but again, check the review. And one of my favorite basses in the world, the Gibson Grabber, the G3. Okay, not the new ones. These are the good ones. Okay, very Gene Simmons-ish. Big Flying V headstock, but I love that bass. Again, check out the reviews. Just one of the best sounding, cool basses. Got a growl like you can't believe. Kicks ass. Kicks total ass. Again, 1976 Gibson Grabber G3 for the three Bill Lawrence pickups that are always... you have those two on in one position, then all three of them on in the middle position, then those two on in the up position. Maple fingerboard, and again, a Flying V headstock. Okay, here's the Giger Iceman again, the guy that did all the Aliens movies and all that stuff, he passed away sometime not too long ago. Still got the plastic on everything. It's just here because it's just here. What else can I say? It's here because it's here. 1978. This is not Carina. They called the Finnish Carina, which confused so many people, Ibanez. IC300. Not to be confused with the nasty Icemans of today. I have no nasty Icemans of today except for this one, which is not nasty. But yeah, this is the cream of the crop back. This is the one I used to sit in study hall and just cream over. Hope I'd get it someday. And I did. There's very few of these, like 100 and some out there in the world. And of course that one is pristine. I love it. Here's just an IC50 from 1982. That's the way the pickups came on all of them. They always did a covered pickup on the neck and just took the cover off, or never put one on for down here. So nothing has been modified on these. That's all original. Just a nice blue without any binding or any fancy stuff. Bolt-on neck from 1982, so a IC50. All the rest of the... That's all of the Iceman. Everything else, everybody keeps saying, oh man, look at all these Ibanez Icemans you got. No, these are all PS10s. These are like $4,000 and above. These are not Icemans, folks. These are Ibanez Custom Shop Paul Stanley signature models. And best way to do it is probably from this end. This is the cream of the crop. 1978, very first year. Everybody's like, why do you have so many that are the same? I've only got one that's the same as another, because these do make a difference. So 1978, right behind it. I won't bore you, because you can see all the original ones, but hey, ta-da, signed. 1979, I have not got the 80 or the 81 yet that have been clean enough for me to buy. This one's never been played. This is the LTD Limited, the highest dollar one they ever made. Unless you come across a totally mint 1978 that Paul owned himself or something. And of course the mirror job. And yes, that's on a PS10. This is one of two limited editions that they did for when the band... Oh God, what was this for? The PS10. Yeah, most people go have the mirror job done on a cheap old IC300 from recently. It's like, hell no. So these are all, like I said, at least $4,000 and above. These are the real deals from every single possible year they ever made them. There's the 20th anniversary of Kiss. Right there. These were made for American... release only, and then these were made for Japan only over there, so had the Japanese one carved up for the mirror job, but otherwise they were identical to begin with. The only one, this one, is the PS10 from Korea from 95 and 96. That's the only one that was not made in Japan. So, and I know there's a new PS10 coming out and a PS1 CR or CM for crack mirror is supposed to be out here in 2015. Then two really cheap ones, one for $299, a little IC40, I think. Then they got another IC120 that's out for like $900 out of Indonesia. So those are out currently, but the new PS10s are not out. Will I get one? I don't know. Okay, so those are all those. They are not Icemans. I know they're shaped like it, but there's definitely a huge difference in quality and definitely a huge difference in monetary value. Let's see. Keep on going. It's all mainly Kiss junk back here. Okay, so this was the Cort Axe guitar, 6-string, but they only made 50 that had the EMG 81 and the 85 in them. So only 50 of those ever made. Here's another one that came out with just the Mighty Mite pickups. The Court one. Why Mighty Mite? Because Court owns Mighty Mite. And these sound phenomenal. Check out the electric guitar test where I've got this up against Les Paul standards and everything. And this here wins big time. The sound of that one over every guitar I put it up against. You'll find it. So that was one of like, you know, six or seven guitars up against all the expensive ones and the Les Pauls and Explorers and everything. And everybody said this one just sounded so much better. And it does. Then here's a third one, which I just reconverted. As you can see, I added a P bass tailpiece to it, like the basses, to make it look more Gene Simmons-ish. I put a roller bridge on it and three lace sensors. And I threw three knobs and a five-way switch in there. So that's my country one. Yes, sirree, Bob. Okay, so here's the real Gene Simmons Axe bass, not the Court model. So this is back in the day when they actually look like this. So that's the real deal. And then you have the Court model behind it, just because you could get it. But these have went up about three times in price since they quit making the things. So very groovy. And let's see, let me plug in a little power supply down here. I think I've got one. Let's see if it's plugged in or not. Hope it is. Dun, 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 dun. Gonna find out in a second if it goes off or stays on. Plug it in, Scott. Where's the hole? I can't find the damn hole. I can't find the hole. I'm sorry. Oh well, we'll see what happens. Anyway, here's the real ones. The Kramers. The first ones. Back in the day. All autographed. There was never 1,000 of these. There was a total of 200 ever made between the 175 bases. Like this. This is the real one with the aluminum necks. So these cost like 10 grand each. So there's the bass. And they made 25 guitars. So I've got two of the guitars, which are, let's see, here's one. Okay. And here's another one of the actual, the original Kramer X guitars that most of you've only ever heard of. 10 grand each. Again, there. Are they worth it? I don't know. We'll find out. Here's the real Punisher. Not the Court models. This is the real deal with the EMGs and blah, 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 the high-end stuff. Here's the Court one, which are way up there again. Now they're up over a grand for just the plain old Court model. Bolt on neck. Here's my new PV Modulus Graphite G5 bass. Hell of a bass. So your 5-string G5 again, Modulus Graphite neck on that sumbitch. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Okay, let's see what's left. Okay, there's the Washburn. That one's got a B-bender on it, Forrest Lee model, and a big Tree of Life vine inlay going on it. The Dark Star silver tone, and this one here beat all my acoustics, Martins, Taylors, everything in a blind study. Yep, this $79 silver tone. You guys picked it, and there it is. The old whatever that was in the 70s or 80s. It's got a number in it. I don't remember what it is. The 83, the Takamine EA360 Flying A, since they weren't allowed to use the term Flying V. So it's your acoustic electric. Had many of those. I love my Rain Song. Graphite guitar. You can take it from the Himalayas to on a volcano and never have any problem with this. There's not a single piece of wood on it. And it just is an amazing flipping guitar. Wacky ass little ukulele, solid body, plug that dude in, take it anywhere. Which I do. It's actually not a bad little unit. Some of them aren't. So they come with a million different names, but just a little cheap thing and you plug in the headphones. Cool thing though. The George Lynch Washburn acoustic electric. I did a review on that recently. Check it out. This here had to be one of the last ones. It's got the wrong electronics in it, which is good for me. It actually has tuners and electronics you can reach. So it's actually a superb axe. My amazing Taylor with the stuff that makes everybody cream. And the matching Coco Bolo strap. But here's the back of that sucker. The Coco Bolo and the sapwood. And that thing is just amazing. And it has, that's a 96. 914 CE Fall Edition, which is just amazing as well, with the Cindy inlays. If you guys are Taylor fans, you'll know what you got. And very proud to own a very special axe that I just won't go into, but this actual, the Curbo, not the court stuff, this is the granddaddy. Yes, another, I know you hate me throwing money out there, but I did have to give 10 G's from that after Ed Roman croaked. This was his personal one, which he obtained from somebody, I'm not telling you who, but that's why it costs so much flipping money. And then all the ones that they're making knockoffs of are directly off of this particular base because it was the best of all of them. So Mr. Greg Curbo passed away as well. But they make awesome axes, and that's a phenomenal flipping base. Again, rock wood on the neck, which is not real wood. So it's a beautiful thing, and it's not going to warp. Okay, so is there anything else? I did the whole backside over there. I did the backside here. I think I got everything, by God. So before the battery dies, good God, 2.5 flipping hours, really? Oh well, it is what it is. So that'll take a month to upload. So again, it's just an old man having fun, and I'm sure there's plenty more things to be coming in. And thanks again for the PV, dude, man. So underrated. All the toys on the ground, more J12s for the big amps. All my stock of DVDs, flash drives, hard drives, everything. This is just what I call home. It's a beautiful deal. And again, thanks for asking to see the update of what's going on in here in my little mad world. And I'm not seeing anything much that I left out. If I did, hey, we'll get it on the next time around. So once again, it is 69, yes, June 9th, 2015, and this is where the guitar collection, this particular collection, stands at the moment. You could see my former collections, which have none of these guitars. I sold them all and started again. So it's always interesting, just to teach you guys about stuff that you may or may not ever see or may never consider, but if you ever get a chance to get an M3, Studio Light M3 Les Paul. Holy crap, what a great guitar, and I'm so glad I got it back. And my friend, if you ever want to sell me my Corvus 3 back, that blue one, let me know. Okay, once again, Scott Grove. Dr. Groovy, I actually went in today and got rid of the back brace in case I want to lift up something heavy, then I have to put it back on, but it's a beautiful thing. Let me go out on this beautiful thing with the Scott Grove band opening up back way back in the day, back in 1975, for cousin Fijel there. Okay, so lots of fun axes. Hope you enjoyed them, and I'll go try to put this together and load it up over the next few days, and always have plenty of humidifiers around, or at least just keep everything where it's supposed to be. So y'all be groovy, and thanks again to everybody who has made me so many cool items over the times and have sent to me. I appreciate every flippin' little thing. If there's anything you ever want to see, let me know. So a whole bunch of reviews on all about a good at least dozen guitars that you haven't seen coming up soon. So I've been given the go ahead and do the reviews. So those are coming up, and some more lessons coming up. And on my website and everywhere else, a whole new slew of paid lessons are going to be coming out. I've found a way to do everything. So as long as I'm alive anyway, you guys are going to get some more stuff. So you guys be groovy, and I shall see you when I see you, okay? Oh, I love my clock, too. Got to show that. Some things I've never even unwrapped. Nice Harley strap there. Awesome. That's it for now. Again, you guys have a blast, okay? Talk to you later. Bye-bye.